Good morning. It's Monday and I'm Nancy Joy, back from Egypt. You know, this quote this week about seeing ourselves not as our human being selves, identified with our names, with our personalities, our careers, whatever, is truly a new way to look at yourself, to understand yourself, and to feel the God creator that you really are. And it just interfaces so well with what went on for me and our group, but of course through my eyes for me in Egypt these past almost 3 weeks. As I said before, we did Egypt in an entirely new way. We didn't go up the chakras like every spiritual group does. We started right in the center. We started at the heart. And it became apparent to me in our very first ceremony that what we were doing at Karnak in the Hall of Creation, that where the Egyptians believed our life rose out of the primordial waters, so there's all these columns, and in those columns we stood, and we connected heart to heart, eye to eye, soul to soul, not our physical selves beyond that, and we created the beginnings of a new higher vibration of a human heart. You know, you start with the male and female, they create the four cells, the create eight, then the human zygote, and the next thing to be created are the 16 cells, and it's my understanding they actually are like a tutorus with even a hole in the middle. And do you know what they are, those first 16 cells? They're the heart. They're the cells that create your heart. The rest of you forms around that. So that's exactly what we did. And then every place we went after that, we were guided to add to create the new being from the heart, that we are vibrating that higher vibration. And I feel for every one of us personally, as well as a group, we truly vibrated at a higher level than we ever imagined would be possible. And I'm excited about this because it really dawned on me. I go there to create new templates, new grids, and I'm, of course, heart lights. I work on the heart and emotional clearing and with Ezekiel, the emotional field. And yet it all came together for me there magically. The passion, the high vibration of love and physicality of God's self that actually began in my own being, I felt to become very powerful, and I saw it reflected all around me. I saw it with Amro, our Egyptian, so much more than a guide, our Egyptian spiritual counterpart, and Gigi, the feminine Egyptian woman who stepped into her role, and the beautiful feminine energy, Kundalini, that moved throughout the group, and yet the strong masculine energy of the two men, out of the nine of us, two men, who held that field of action so that we could create in our womb this new heart. So how do we apply that to moving into and beyond 2012? Well, exactly this quote, like as David Icke put it, as long as we look in the mirror, as long as I look in the mirror and I see Nancy Joy, as long as I worry about everything that's happening in this lifetime, I'm caught in the illusion that I created to move beyond it all. So it's so important creating beyond 2012 and understanding what that really means in our emotions, in our cells, in our hearts. And so I'm expanding the To Love It All retreats. You still need the emotional clearing, so you need to be clear enough to step into God's self and not keep getting pulled back into your old patterns. And so I drew a card from the Osho deck there, flowering. And I feel that's what's going on. Not only do I feel I am flowering, I feel that the world is of consciousness is flowering in human beings through the new human heart. I mean, you know, I could sit there and say, oh, surely we didn't create that. But you know what? We did create it. And we created it because we're conscious that that's what we did. And that's the beauty of it. So consider joining us for one of the next two or three Creating Beyond 2012 retreats here at El Shaddai. Still, yes, emotional clearing work, but at a much higher vibratory level. We don't need all the drama to understand what's really happening here, but we need community and we need group heart, even as it says in the Bible, wherever two or more are gathered. Well, it's time to gather in groups and breathe life into this new heart and take it with us and activate it in the world. And so I hope you'll consider joining us for spring equinox, March 21st and 22nd, for summer solstice, the 20th and the 21st, and even on to September to fall equinox right here at El Shaddai. Let's create beyond 2012 and let's do it together. And this Monday morning, try looking at yourself beyond your human self. Really concentrate on the miracle of the God, Creator God that you are. And have a great week. We'll see you again next week. Bye.